So I just want to explain briefly about the significance of initiation in the Krishna consciousness movement.
我想介绍一下在昆士的知觉运动之中的启迪的含义。
There are two kinds of initiation. One is first of the first initiation is the initiation into the chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra, and also the strictly following of the four regulative principles.
一种启迪是要被称为是唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra 的启迪，而且呢，你要努力的严格遵守四项规范原则。
Of the two initiations, the first initiation is the most important.
在两种启迪之中，第一次启迪是最重要的。
对，你现场做的启迪吗？你现场启迪。
告诉希望彩排那爬坡，让他们把这个大屏幕的麦关了，别打扰给我讲课。
So the first initiation is the most important one. The first initiation is chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, and it's the Maha mantra which will take you back to Godhead.
第一次启迪是最重要的，因为第一次启迪是让你能够唱诵 Hare Krishna Mantra， 而这种对圣名的唱诵可以带你回归守神。
And the second initiation is to help you to do further devotional service, to take more responsibilities in Krishna consciousness.
二次启迪是为了让你能够做更多的服务，让你能够在 Krishna 知觉之中取得更多的进步，做更多的服务。
Sometimes they call the second initiation as the mantra initiation because you're giving the Gayatri mantra to chant.
有的时候大家也管二次启迪叫做 mantra 启迪，因为会给你 Gayatri mantra 去唱诵。
But the first initiation is connecting you into the Krishna consciousness movement and connecting you to the disciplic succession.
而第一次启迪是让你跟 Krishna 知觉运动联系在一起，让你跟使徒传系联系在一起。
Actually, there's no initiation required for chanting Hare Krishna. Anyone, anywhere can chant Hare Krishna mantra.
其实只是为了唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra 的话都不需要启迪，任何人在任何地方都可以唱诵 Hare Krishna Mahamantra。
But if you want to chant to get the real goal of the chanting, then you will help. You need the help of a spiritual teacher, you need to be connected to a spiritual society, and for that purpose there is initiation.
但是如果你要想真正取得唱诵的结果，你必须要跟一位灵性的老师有关系，你必须要跟一个灵性的协会有关系，这是为什么我们让大家接受一次启迪。
If you just want to chant Hare Krishna, you don't want to do anything else, then that's up to you. You know, you can do that.
如果你只是想唱诵 Hare Krishna, 然后你不想做别的，那你就这样做吧，没有关系的。
But if you want to understand the teachings of Krishna consciousness,and you want to practice the process seriously, then you do require initiation.
但是如果你想明白这个 Krishna 知觉的具体的含义，你想能够在这个使徒传承之中取得更多的进步，你的确是需要启迪的。
So in order to get initiation from the spiritual teacher, there are some requirements.
为了得到灵性的老师的启迪，需要满足一些条件。
One of the things is you have to attend what is called the disciple course.
其中的一个项目是你必须要参加门徒课程。
Now, attending the disciple course is not a qualification in itself for initiation. You still have to get, there's still other things.
参加门徒课程本身并不能够让你具备资格去启迪，还有其他的方面。
you have to be recommended by the devotees who are leading and who are operating the different Krishna conscious programs.
你必须要得到推荐，你必须要得到那些组织参加 Krishna 知觉活动，就是说节目的这些奉献者的推荐。
You have to be following strictly the four regulative principles.
你必须要严格地遵守四项规范原则。
And you have to be chanting a minimum of 16 rounds every day.
而且每一天你必须要唱诵至少16圈。
So when you've done that for a minimum period of 6 months, then you become, you may be recommended for initiation.
当你做这个至少六个月的时候，可以得到推荐启迪。
No.
可以托币 ，I'm sorry， 可以托币，托币，得到推荐的这个得到推荐去托币。
First you get recommendation, and then after, then there will be a testing period between the, both the disciple and the spiritual teacher.
先去托币，然后就会进入一个考验期，就是门徒和灵性导师互相考验。
Yeah, when you purchase something.You want to know what is it a good quality or is it just some fake?
你如果买一个东西的话，你也想检查一下，你买的这个东西是质量好，还是说是一个假货
？If you buy some, you know, electronic device and it's just some fake thing, then it will break very quickly.
如果你要是买一个电子产品，如果是冒牌的，那很快就坏掉。
I was with one devotee one time. There's this one big market in Bangkok, and it's a Sunday market, just on Sunday. So this devotee came from America, and he saw this bag, which was a very famous brand name, and he thought, oh, you know, that's a very good bag, and he immediately went and purchased the bag.
在曼谷的时候，有一次我跟一个奉献者去市场，那是一个只有星期天才开的市场。然后在这个市场上呢，我们这个奉献者他就看到，他是美国来的，他就看到有一个包特别好，是一个名牌，他就想立刻把这个包买下来。结果第二天他的这个包就全破了，是个冒牌货。
Same way, sometimes you know you may want to get a spiritual teacher. You want to make sure you're getting the real thing.
你要确保你找到一个真正的灵性的老师，你能得到真正的东西。
If you don't know what is the qualification of a spiritual teacher, then you're easily cheating.
如果你不知道一位真正的灵性导师的资格是什么呢，很容易你就会受到欺骗。
And similarly, a spiritual teacher wants to be sure he's getting a genuine disciple.
而同样道理，一位真正的灵性的老师想能够确保他得到的是一位真诚的、真正的门徒。
Because sometimes people come and say, "Oh yes, I'm chanting every day 16 rounds. Oh yes, I'm following the principle."
因为有的时候人们来了就会说，哦，是啊，我每天都在念诵十六圈，遵守四项规范原则。
But in course of time, it's shown that they're not following very strictly.
但是随着时间的流逝，我们就会发现他们遵守规范原则并不严格。
So it's not a very good thing if people come into Krishna consciousness. Student is also tested.
我们要非常的严肃，然后要注重这个考验期。老师，灵性的老师得到考验，门徒也要得到考验。
If you get something very easy, it's not very valuable.
如果你轻易的就能够得到一样东西的话，这个没有多少价值。
We say 一分钱一分货。
我们说一分钱一分货。
好标准。
Yeah, when you go shopping, I often see that sign in the shop.
好地道啊。
You know, 一分钱 ，you get what you pay for.
有时候你们去买东西，就会在商店里看到这样的标识：一分钱一分货。也就是说，你所得到的跟你的付出是成正比的。如果你得到很容易的就得到启迪的话，你就不会重视它。
So we try to make people, we try to give more and more tests to people so that they will value more their initiation.
我们要给人们很多的考验，这样呢，他们通过考验之后再启迪，就会非常的珍视这种启迪。
And that's especially true with the second initiation.
What is the initiation?
哦，
尤其是二次启迪
more,
甚至是更加的严格 二次启迪有的时候也叫做 Brahmana 的启迪
so Brahmana should have some knowledge. They should know what's in the scriptures.
Brahmana 应该有知识他们应该知道经典上都写了什么
so therefore,Usually for second initiation, we will ask the devotee, you first of all complete what is called the Bhakti Shastri course.
一般来讲呢，对于那些想要二次启迪的奉献者，我们要求他们必须要完成 Bhakti Shastri 课程的学习。
Bhakti Shastri course is studying, making a study of the Bhagavad Gita and other small books like Ishopanishad, Upadesha Amrita, Nectar of Devotion.
Bhakti Shastri 的这个课程要求大家学习 Bhagavad Gita 博迦梵歌原意还有一些小书 Ishopanishad Upadeshamrita 还有奉爱的甘露
And the students who study this course they have to write some essays they have to answer they have to do a little test a memory a closed book test and they have to memorize also some slokas
学生参加这些课程的学习他们不仅要写作业而且还要有闭卷的考试还要写论文还要一就是记住一些梵文的诗节
So everyone's encouraged to do this. Older people also.
每一个人都受到鼓励要完成这个课程即使是年纪大了也应该做
In China, we have a nice program for the older people, 老年大学
在中国我们有非常好的一个老年人的项目叫做老年大学
And they get more slower instruction. They learn in a more gradual manner.
老年人他们学习的时候呢，步骤可以慢一些，还可以慢慢的去学习。
Because they come to Krishna consciousness later in life.
因为他们是在生命的后期进入 Krishna 知觉的。
So it takes longer for them to learn it.
所以对他们来讲，需要更长的时间来学习。
So we have this nice program so that they can learn at their own speed.
这样我们有这个节目的安排，所以他们可以按照自己的步骤来学习。
So today initiation, we're giving some two people will take the first initiation. I will give to one lady the first initiation. Then Jayantakata Swami Maharaj will also be giving to one.
今天我要启迪一个门徒然后我启迪完了之后呢加帕塔克马哈哈也会启迪一个门徒
And another lady will receive also second initiation. She will be given the Gayatri Mantra privately.
另外一位女士她将接受二次启迪她就是会在这个私密的情况下接受 Gayatri Mantra.
Gayatri Mantra means you're ready to chant another 210 mantras.
Gayatri mantra 就意味着你每天要多念诵210个 mantra.
Right? We chant. There are 7 mantras to be chanted 3 times a day and 10 each mantra 10 times each time. So 7 times 3 times 10 is 210. That means you're going to chant in addition to 16 rounds, you're going to chant another 210 mantras.
二次启迪就意味着你每一天要多念诵210个 mantra 因为 Gayatri mantra 一共有七个每一个 mantra 应该念十遍然后呢每一天这些 mantra 应该念三次所以呢就是七乘以十然后再乘以三就等于210
So if you struggle to chant Hare Krishna mantra in a few rounds then you're not ready to chant Gayatri mantra
如果每天念诵十六圈你还非常的挣扎就是很挣扎才能念个几圈那你也没法念诵 Gayatri Mantra
yeah, it takes practice, you know, in the beginning, we're not accustomed to be chanting one or two rounds, gradually
需要时间需要练习在一开始的时候可能只能念诵个一两圈逐渐的
but sometimes some people have, you know Maybe some people they're connected only from their past life and they take to this very quickly.
但有的人可能跟他们潜意识有关，他们可以很迅速地接受这个修行。其他的人他们是需要更循序渐进一些。Slow and steady wins
the race. Slow and steady wins the race.
我们说有一句俗语叫做慢而且稳一定会去，就是会赢的。
You go very fast in the beginning, you're easily turning.
你在跑的时候，一开始跑得特别快，然后后来可能就没劲儿了。
The hare, you know the story, the hare and the tortoise.
你们都听说过那个兔子和乌龟赛跑的故事吗？
听说过。
你们。
So we don't want to be too much like the hare. Take it gradually and come along.
我们不想像兔子一样，我们想逐渐的接受，然后一直的保持下去。
So chanting Hare Krishna, there are 10 offenses to be avoided in chanting. Quality is important.
唱诵 Hare Krishna 的时候要注意避免十项冒犯，唱诵的质量是最重要的。
So most important is that we should chant with attention.
最重要的是我们应该非常专注的去唱诵。
From inattentive chanting, all of these other offenses come.
所有其他的那些冒犯都来自于不专注的唱诵。
So you have to chant with attention. You have to put the mind into when you're chanting, and you have to hear. You use the tongue to chant and the ear to hear.
我们在唱诵的时候必须全神贯注，我们在唱诵的时候是用舌头去唱诵，用耳朵去聆听。
You don't have to use the mind, you have to chant, use the tongue to chant and the ears to hear.
你不需要运用到心意，必须要用舌头去唱诵，用耳朵去聆听。
So we conquer our mind by chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
我们通过唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 征服我们的心意。
Every day we have a battle with the mind.
每一天我们都要跟心意打仗。
The mind is saying, "Oh no, not again."
心意说，哦不，又来了。
Oh no, not this chanting. We chanted yesterday. I have to chant today.
心意说，哦，今天怎么又得念诵啊？我们昨天刚念诵完。
They have to train the mind. They train the mind.Right? And you train it by not listening to that kind of mind, but by loudly chanting the holy name.
我们必须要训练我们的心意。我们训练我们的心意的方法就是通过大声的唱诵主的圣名。
So we encourage all the devotees, you know, chant with care and attention. Make it a regular program. Try to chant early in the morning. It's better than later in the day.
我们鼓励大家非常专注认真的去念诵，而且呢这个念诵要有规律，最好是在早晨的时候念诵，这个比你在这一天之中晚一些时候念诵效果更好。
But chanting can be done anytime. There are no rules. You can chant anytime and any place.
但是唱诵没有硬性规则，任何时候都可以做，你可以在任何时间任何地点去唱诵。
But some things make it easier.
但是有一些事情可以让你的唱诵更容易，早晨清晨如果你去唱诵的话非常的有力量。大声一点唱诵，不要在你的心意里唱诵，你要把这个音发出来，大声的去唱诵。
Okay, so.
可以吗？
So we're going to give the initiation first for this one lady. Mariti, you go to Prabhupada Vyasasan, or make to Prabhupada Vyasasan, and then goodbye, Prabhupada, go on. So I'm going to introduce you to this lady.
我给大家介绍一下这位女士。
Her name is Dai Yu.
她的名字是戴玉飞。
戴玉飞。So she has been practicing for about 3 years.
她大概修习了三年。
She's a yoga teacher.
她是一位瑜伽老师。
And she also makes very nice sweets.
而且她会做很好吃的甜品。
She's loved making sweets.
她很喜欢做甜品。
And she's associating with our devotees here.
她
The devotees were from her city.
她跟当地的奉献者一起联谊。
This is Tapana Mishra Prabhu and his wife, Deva Shanti. They have a small group in their city and she associates with them every week.
我们这里有 Tapana Mishra Prabhu 和他的好妻子Devi Shakti Mataji. 他们在当地有一个小组，所以这个戴 Mataji 就一直跟他们一起在联谊。
So we've been helping her and preparing her for initiation.
这一对夫妇一直在帮助她，培养她，为了得到启迪。第一次见面是两三年之前吗？我去过他的家乡。我们在他的那个房子里做过一个节目。现在他准备好了，可以接受启迪了。Maharaj is asking her about the four regulative principles.
So we give you the name Devaki Priya Devi Dasi.
Hari Guru, 我们给你名字 Devaki Priya Devi Dasi. Devaki Priya Devi Dasi Ki.
Devaki is the mother of Lord Krishna. That's Devaki and Vasudev. They were Krishna's mother and father in Mathura.
Devaki 是 Krishna 的母亲 Devaki 和 Vasudeva 他们在 Mathura 是 Krishna 的母亲和父亲
Later on they moved to Dwarka
之后他们搬到了 Dwarka
So Devaki is the mother of Lord Krishna
因此 Devaki 就是主 Krishna 的母亲
So you're the dear servant
你是他的亲爱的仆人、
So thank you very much
非常感谢你
go back to Prabhupada, offer obeisances.
再回到帕帕那里顶拜两三分钟之后圣座加帕塔克斯瓦米马哈拉就会上线启迪门徒我现在给大家介绍一下接受二次启迪的这位女士 Gita Govinda Devi Dasi你多长时间了奉献者当多长时间 7 years、
huh?
7 years、
yeah. But she's been a devotee for 7 years and she did very nice wonderful service and she opened a small bakery in her city where she's living she opened a bakery and she was making every day she was making so manyMantou, Tianxin, and Gary Yoko Chong, the.
How to the Chong?
Gita Govinda Mataji, he has been a volunteer for 7 years. He has done a lot of work in the country, and he has opened a Govinda Juice Den. He has made mantou, tianpin, and he has made a lot of good things. Bows,
jiaozi,
momo, dumplings.
Yeah.And now she's giving that shop, she gave it to another devotee lady to take care of.
现在她把这个店转让给另外的一个奉献者，一个 Mataji 去照顾了。
And she's putting more of her time into training and educating the other devotees.
现在他把自己的时间主要用于去教育，然后帮助其他的奉献者。
Because initially she was living in a big city and she moved to a smaller place. In a smaller town, they don't get so much attention.
那么一开始的时候他住在一个很大的城市，后来他搬到了一个小地方去，在这个小地方没有得到很多的涟漪。
Okay, okay.